This is a pre-built version of the application. So we'll have two peers. That are using elliptic curve Diffie-Hellman key exchange to generate a shared secret key between them, meaning a point on the curve. And we'll also have this eavesdropper peer. So it will be picking up messages from the two communicating peers. And this one will pick up messages from this one. And this one from this one. And I have test data here, so we'll use an elliptic curve with those domain parameters. So we have those two values for A and B, the curve coefficients, and this value for P, the prime number, and this one for n, the number of points in the cyclic subgroup, and this one for h, the cofactor. And we'll use this generator point that would generate the cyclic subgroup. And Alice picks this secret key and uses it to calculate her public key. So we have three hops from the generator point, and we end up at this point. And Bob picks this secret key. So we have 10 hops and use it to calculate his public key B. So 10 hops from the generator point. And they both calculate the common key, which ends up being the same. So here we have three hops from the public key of Bob. So we end up here, and here we have 10 hops from the public key of Alice, and we end up here. And passive Eve can see all the communications. So now she knows the domain parameters that Alice entered into the system. And she knows the X and Y coordinates for Alice's public key, and the X and Y coordinate for Bob's public key. So here passive Eve have a starting point, meaning the generator point, and ending point, or Alice's public key, and she needs to obtain Alice's secret key meaning the number of halves or lowercase a, and use it to calculate the common key, meaning the shared final endpoint. And this is the elliptic curve, discrete logarithm problem, the elliptical curve analog of computing a discrete logarithm, or she could have tried to obtain Bob's secret key and use it to calculate the common key. So she has Bob's public key, and she has a generator point, which is a starting point, and Bob's public key would be the ending point. So the secret key for Bob would be the number of halves from the starting point to the ending point. And I want to also run in hexadecimal mode, so base 16. So we'll be using this curve, the one used by Bitcoin, and those are the values for the domain parameters that we'll be using. So let's go ahead and start the two communicating peers and the eavesdropper one. This one will be picking up messages from the two communicating ones, and this one from this one, and this one from this one. So pick up those domain parameters. For the purpose of this prototype project, we'll have the first user that logs in enter those domain parameters, so Alice in this case, and this is generator point X and Y coordinates. And passive Eve can see all the domain parameters. So the generator point, the X and Y coordinates for that, and H and N and P and A and B. Now let's say that Alice picks this secret key and use it to calculate her public key. This is A, the point A, the public key for Aleph, the coordinate for that point. So we have this number of halves from G, the generator point. This one. And Bob picks, let's say, this secret key, and he calculates his public key, so uppercase B, this point with those coordinates. So we have this number of hops from the generator point. And now they both calculate the common key, which ends up being the same for both of them. And passive Eve can see the X and the Y coordinates for the public key for Aleph, and the X and Y coordinates for the public key for Bob. So passive Eve have a starting point, the generator point, and an ending point, meaning Alice's public key or Bob's public key, and she needs to obtain Alice's secret key or Bob's secret key, meaning the number of hops from the generator point to Alice's public key, or from the generator point to Bob's public key. And if she obtains Alice's or Bob's secret key, she can use it to calculate the common key, meaning the shared final endpoint. Now, the source code for this prototype project will be available for download. Also, a longer version will be available for channel members, and it will include the writing and the test running of the code.